Good evening and welcome to the Business Day. I'm Andrea Chisholm. The Planning Institute of Jamaica, PIOJ, today added its voice to ongoing concerns that the world could be heading towards a recession. Director General Dr. Wayne Henry was speaking at a quarterly press briefing. TVJ's Andrew Laidley has that story.
The PIOJ admitted today that it has revised its near-term outlook for economic growth downward. Director General Dr. Wayne Henry says although economic growth is expected, the signs of a global economic slowdown has impacted the original forecast.
Our numbers have come down, you said, to the 0.5 to 1.5% in the near term. Still growth, but you would have heard us say before that we're Some time ago would have been to the one to two, and you're seeing some weakening there. But we expect that we have, and the country has been building some resilience, and we continue to encourage and expect that to go forward.
Dr. Henry says there are measures the country can put in place to mitigate the impact, starting with stronger trade policies.
The intensity of any global recession is usually exacerbated by policy uncertainty. As such, policymakers have a critical responsibility to ensure that there is certainty surrounding policies related to external trade and other macroeconomic fundamentals.
He says labor market conditions, which is the other indicator used to predict a recession, do not suggest a recession is likely to materialize before 2021. But he says work needs to be done to improve the competitiveness of Jamaica's labor force.
At the industry level, retooling and training to improve productivity and competitiveness. It has been demonstrated that the most competitive companies are usually better equipped to withstand the challenges arising from a recession.
The PIOJ projects that economic growth for the current financial year should range between 1 to 2%. But the Planning Institute notes that domestic factors such as adverse weather conditions could also confine growth to the lower end of the forecast. Andrew Laidley, TVJ News.
Currency trading ended today with the US dollar selling for $136.68, the Canadian dollar $103.78. The pound is going for $165.44, while the euro sells for $151.42. To the stock market now, the JSE index lost 804 points today and the junior market index declined by 35 points. Among the winners, ISP Finance Services, Caribbean Cream, Consolidated Bakeries, Indus Pharma and Carib Cement. On the losing side, we had G-West Corporation, Cygnus Credit Investments USD Shares, Caribbean Flavors and Fragrances, T-Tech and Jetcon Corporation. And that's the Business Day. I'm Andrea Chisholm. Good evening.